What is up, people? So welcome back to another video. Today we will be seeing about how you can make topic wise notes for CSC exam in the latest version of Evernote, because the user interface of this Evernote version is changed. So subscribe to this channel to get such more videos, and also if you are using the older version of Evernote, you can see the video in the I button which I have mentioned in the top right corner. So this is the new version, and in this home tab you need not do anything. So I will show you the version which I am using currently right now, so you can just pause the video and see whether this version is only you are also using, so it will be easier for you to make the notes. So coming back to the Evernote software, so first thing is that you should have your CSC notification opened with you so that you can easily make the notes. And yeah, the 2021 notification, and since the exam has been postponed to October, so you have plenty of time to make the notes and also revise them. So go to page number 30. In that you will get this preliminary exam syllabus of paper 1 of 200 marks. So first we will be making the topic wise note framework of this preliminary exam. For current affairs, this is newspaper reading and current affairs magazine, and history of India is Spectrum, Bipin Chandra and NCERT books. And then comes the world geography. For this, the NCERT books and Oxford School Atlas is what I'm following. And also you can go through the news articles which give you the various recent occurring geographical phenomena. And for the Indian polity, Lakshmikant is the book to go for. Along with that, you can supplement with newspaper editorials. So next comes economics and social issues. Here the economic survey and budget is important, along with various economic terms like balance of payment and various policies of RBI and commodity markets and all. So this is also related to newspaper reading and current affairs. And then here general issues on environmental ecology. This also mostly it is all current affairs based. So, and the general science, this is also current affairs based. So most of these can be solved if you have a good knowledge of current affairs and have a good concept of the basic things. So jumping back to the Evernote, in the home tab there are various customization features which frankly I don't find any use of them because many of them are locked for the premium version. However, we will not be using the premium and we will be using the basic version. So if you are a premium user, you can customize this thing. However, in this video we will not be using this home tab. We'll go to this notebooks tab. Here the main things come. You will prepare your notes here, and then you can also revise your notes from this. So in this notebooks tab, you can see that currently there are no notebooks existing. By default they will give you the first notebook. So we will be creating all those step by step, so keep watching this video. So coming back to the notification in the preliminary examination section, so we will create topic wise monthly notes. Like every month we will collect notes and then we will revise them. So that is our main plan here. So first thing is that we will rename this first notebook. We will take it as January 2021. So right click on that and rename the book to January 2021. Since the prelims is in October, so the current affairs from January to September will be sufficient. If you have a decent knowledge about the various events occurring, and then we will go to this here, right click, add to stack, and then we will create a new stack. This is important because many of you keep asking in the comment section how to do this stack thing. So follow this video here carefully and you will be easily getting to know how to create the stack. So we will name the stack as prelims, and then create, we will press the create button and see that stack has been created. And inside the stack there is this Jan 2021 notebook which we have created right now. So this is how the stack works in Evernote. So if you did not understand, just rewind and watch this video again. It is very easy concept. Once you get to understand this, it will be useful. And then again right click on the prelims stack and create new notebook. Now February 2021. And it will gradually create this new notebook here. So inside the prelims stack there is Jan 2021 and Feb 2021. again right click, create new notebook, March 2021. So in this way, you will be creating the notebooks for every corresponding month. So you have to just right click on the stack and then create new notebook. So I am forwarding this video here till you can see here the monthly current affairs notebooks which you have created inside this prelim stack. So here you can just copy paste whichever source you are following. So for example, in the insights, we can copy paste this article in the Jan 2021, and beside this panel you can see here plus new button. So you can press on that and a new note emerges inside the Jan 2021, and then you can press the, you can paste the heading there, and also correspondingly you can copy whichever thing you consider is that important, copy that and paste it in your Evernote. You can also customize this note, like you can change the style of header, you can make the fonts bigger, and also you can change the font style. Like there are various script, handwritten, everything is there, so feel free to do whichever font type you want, and also you can change the font size. So I feel the 16 is best, and also you can change the color of the text. So these are the basic features. If you want, you can use them easily. So yeah, basically these are about the main features. So next, currently we have finished the preliminary exam part regarding the dynamic section, because static you anyhow you have to study from those books. So next, page number I think 32, we can see here that the general studies paper 1 syllabus has there. So now we will be creating the main syllabus, which is general studies paper 1. So there is plenty of content here, but no worries, if we organize our notes properly we can easily able to make the notes and as well as revise them. So first we will be creating this Indian culture. So new notebook, okay, first click on new notebook and then Indian culture. Just follow this step and it will be easy for you to understand. Then once you have created this Indian culture, right click on that notebook and then you should press this add to stack, and then we will be creating a new stack. Don't add it to prelims part, this will be the GS1. So new stack, GS1, create. So as you can see here, the Indian culture has been substituted in this GS1 section, so it has become a part of GS1. So you can just create a new note and create whichever content you want. Like in Indian culture there are various things, like architecture is there, art forms are there, literature is there. So you can copy paste these micro parts of the syllabus and keep them as heading of the section, so that whichever content regarding the art forms, literature and architecture, you can easily make your notes there, and you can easily able to find like in which part of the syllabus where I have my notes. So it will be easier for you to organize. And then modern Indian history. So again, in the GS1, right click, new notebook, paste that modern Indian history here, continue. So here you can see that modern Indian history notebook has been created inside the GS1 part. So similarly, again you can create various new notes under this, and you can customize your notebook in your own way. That is up to you, because I'll be giving only the basic framework about how I am preparing notes. So other than that, if you want anything more, you can just feel free to experiment yourself. And then we will be creating the other notes, like redrawal of national boundaries, and so these things, if you think the syllabus is very vast, so you can divide your syllabus, like for each topic you can create the new notes, so that you can easily able to study directly to the source. Like you need not wander around the whole syllabus part. So break your syllabus into small parts and then create those corresponding notebooks under the GS1 tab. And many of you were asking how to add images into Evernote. So for example, if I go to Google Images and World War I timeline, so this image is there, I want to add this to Evernote. So simply I will just copy this image from my browser and then I will go to my Evernote and paste it, Control V. So once I paste my image, the Evernote software will embed that image into my notebook. See here. So now this image will be with you. If you sync it, you can access this image on your web browser and also in your Evernote mobile app. So it is quite an easy thing to do. And So we have completed the GS1 part of the syllabus. See, every topic I have created here under this GS1 stack. So it will be easy for me to make the notes. So yeah. So since we have created the notes of prelims and GS1, so the next thing which comes is the GS2 syllabus, which we have to create now. So let's head back to the notification and we will go to this GS2 part of the syllabus, the governance, constitution, politics, social justice and international relations. So first, this Indian constitution, we will copy this text here, okay, and then create new notebook here by pressing the green button and then paste that here. So again, as you know, right click on that just now created new notebook, add to stack, and then we will create a new stack. This time we will name it as GS2. So yeah, type that GS2 and create. So the Indian constitution note which we have just created got nested in the GS2 stack. See how easy it is. Once you get hold of the software, you can really easily organize your notes and save a lot of time in your preparation. And then the next part of the syllabus, functions and responsibilities, here also we will create this another new note in the GS2 stack, and likewise all the various parts of the GS2 syllabus, just copy them from the notification, whichever thing you want to create the note of, and then paste it in your Evernote stack. So I'll just forward this video here. So finally we have done this GS2 part also, and this was how you can create the GS2 syllabus. See, everything is there here. You can just go to the corresponding notebook and create the various notes which you like. You can easily search them, so you need not worry about losing your notes here. If you just regularly sync it, like weekly once if you sync your notes, it will be saved in your cloud. So now GS3. So again, green button, new notebook. So paste the GS3 first part of the syllabus, create, then right click on that new notebook which you have created, right click on that, add to stack, new stack. So GS3, this one we will name it as GS3, create. So you can see here right now GS3 part of the syllabus has been created. So we will be adding more things in this GS3 stack. So copy this inclusive growth and issues arising from it, go to your Evernote, right click on the GS3 stack, create new notebook, paste it. Similarly, government budgeting, so again copy this, go to your Evernote and paste it. So like this, if you keep on doing this, you will get all the parts of the syllabus of the GS3 here. So you can very well organize your notes. As you can see here, everything is just crystal clear here, whatever things you want. You can also divide your notes, as I have said earlier, so it will be easy for you to find the syllabus, especially in this GS4 section ethics. There are various keywords here which UPSC usually asks the questions, so just break the GS4 part of the syllabus and prepare topic wise notes, that will be most useful. So here again, same thing, add to stack, new stack, GS4. You can name this notebooks anything you want. Like if you want, you prefer ethics, then you can name them as ethics. So feel free to name whatever type of notebook you want to do here. So finally we have created this GS4 also. So case studies most important. So yeah, case studies mostly about using a newspaper, current affairs, whatever things happen, like, you know, well, the previous year pattern of the question. So like that, we can easily create those notes here. So once I just see all those notes here, GS1, 2 and 3, 4 and at the last, prelims, monthly current affairs. So yeah, this is now the next part would be this tags. Like only these two things I use, the notebooks and tags. So press this new tag button here on the right side. You can create tags, like this is all up to you. Like if I want, I can create this Indian history and create this new tag, and again I can create another tag like world history. So I will tell you how you can use this tag. So like biodiversity, poverty, social security. So all these tags I'm creating here. So for example, if I go to GS1 world history, the image, World War One image. So here you can see here at the bottom side, you can see this add tag. So when I add a tag here, like world history, it will show the recent tag which I created. So I can assign my tag to that. So the use of using tags is that, see, once this tag gets assigned to the notebook, I can go to my tags and I can search by tags. Like if I press this world history tab, you can see the notebook which is assigned as world history will emerge in front of you. So like this, you can assign various tags to notebooks and you can easily read your newspaper or current affairs sources in a topic-wise manner. So these are the two things which I use in Evernote, and everything else is by default. So if you are a premium user, you can unlock various other features, but I do not find them much of a use. So yeah, basic features would suffice for the CSV preparation. So if you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and also you can subscribe to the Brand's channel to get such regular videos. So thank you guys for watching this video. We will meet again in the next video. Till then, keep hustling.